Let's get up and take a closer look. It's a huge, heavy forging, and everything is forged in one solid piece except the trunnion band right here and the breech strap, which is what locks the breech in place. There's an operating lever, which we've more or less faithfully reproduced, that rat tail looking thing down there. Here's the breech block, which is lined with copper so that it'll hold up better with the blast from the vent. And you see the extractor has a cartridge extractor. You see the extractor well, and there's the smooth bore barrel, which is actually quite smooth for something this old. So anyway, let's take a look all the way around. Yeah. Very good.
So you don't want any more about right there.
Okay. Go ahead and try it again. Okay. Cool. So that weapon really works pretty well, and you could get quite a few rounds off per minute with this system if you had a good crew. And okay, folks, good morning. We're going to make a little video right now on the Joseph Whitworth's original breech-loading cannon, which is, this is it. Go ahead and open it up, Butch, and let's take a look. It opens quite easily, especially since there's no powder fouling or anything. And nothing's been done to this. This is the original surface, except we did put a little bit of oil on it, so it works smoothly all the time. You see the vent is centrally located back in there. One thing to note about the threads is that they're double threads. You see? Oh, that's great. Yeah, just tap it on something so it turns on, Butch. It's got a bad connection. Now move it back a little bit. Okay, push it in a little bit. There you go. Push it in a little more. Okay, good. Anyway, you can see that's pretty interesting, and it's a lot more accurate method than having to pick up the trail with a trail hand spike and move the whole trail this way and that way. You just kind of see that it's lined up with the double thread and turn it like that. And you're done. And go ahead and open it up again, Butch. Okay, and close it again, please. See how easy that is? This is ordnance and so forth. So let's take another overall look at Whitworth's first breech loading cannon. Circa 1860, there's a wonderful picture that we'll splice into the video of the Royal Artillery troops testing this same piece in Liverpool in about 1860. And we got that picture copied from one that's in the Royal Army Museum in London. Any questions? Thank you. Say goodbye, Butch.
Goodbye.